Welcome to my channel, Megatronics by K. Vijay Kumar. So, as this channel is there for the intention of sensors and transducers, right? So, today we will see what is the basic difference between a sensor and a transducer, and different types of transducers and sensors which are available from our side. Okay, come here. So, sensor and transducer, right? What is the basic difference between the sensor and a transducer? So, first we will see what is the basic definition of a sensor. So, sensor means what? It which converts one form of energy into equivalent another form of energy. So, that is what basically a sensor, right? Which converts one form of energy into another form of energy. What is our one form of energy? That one form of energy can be a pressure, can be a temperature, can be a humidity, which converts into equivalent another form of energy. That another form may be electrical, may not be a electric, non-electric. It may be electrical or it may be a non-electrical quantity. Okay. What is transducer? Again, this is also same thing, which converts one form of energy into equivalent electrical output. Okay. You got the difference? Transducer means what? Which converts one form of energy into equivalent electrical output. So, you see the difference between sensor and transducer. Sensor means what? Which converts one form of energy into equivalent another form of energy. This another form of energy need not to be a electrical. That can be a non-electrical. But in case of transducer, it converts one form of energy, that may be physical quantity, into output electrical quantity. The output has to be an electrical one. Okay? So, this is what the basic difference between sensor and transducer. Got it? Now, definition part has been covered. Right? Now, what are active transducer and passive transducer? Right? From the name itself, it indicates what is active transducer means what? The transducer which gives an electrical output without any external electrical input. Right? Which gives an electrical output without providing any external input source for the generation of output. Passive transducer which generates output. For this, we require some biasing voltage. So, here some input voltage need to be provided for the working of that transistor. That is what your passive transistor, right? That comes mechanical transistor and electrical transistor, right? So, what are mechanical transistors? Which converts physical quantity into a mechanical output. That is what a mechanical transistor. So, what are the you can say examples? One is thermocouple, right? You know thermocouple? So, when two dissimilar metals are joined together, and to this joint if you provide a heat, at the output side we are getting EMF, electromotive force, right? EMF, right, means what? Electrons are driven by some force, right? So, input is what? My temperature, where two metal joints are being connected, to which we are providing the heat. Then output side we are getting an EMF, that is nothing but a voltage also. So, normally we are seeing it as a EMF. That is what your thermocouple. Then what is electrical transducer, in which the mechanical input is converted and we are getting the output as a electrical output voltage. So, for that we are giving a photovoltaic cell, right? What is a photovoltaic cell? In which the light is an input. So, depending upon the intensity of the light, the output electrical signal will be generated. More the intensity of the light, more the electrical voltage. Less the intensity of the light, less the electric voltage. So, this is your photovoltaic cell. Then comes your analog transducer and digital transducer, right? So, from the name itself indicates what is analog transducer means what? Which generates analog output. What are the physical quantity we are measuring at the input side? The output, analog output will be generated. So, that is known as analog output. So, and what are the examples which are coming? What are the transducers which are coming under this analog transducer is thermocouple, LVDT and strain gauge. Now, LVDT means what? Linear variable displacement transducer. Means what? Iron core is placed between primary and secondary winding, and depending upon the movement or displacement of iron core, accordingly your voltage will be generated. So, what is the use of this LVDT? From this we can easily measure the displacement of an object. So, for detecting the displacement of the object, we are using LVDT. Then comes strain gauge. So, normally whenever we want to measure force or a pressure, both are same. Force for this area, right? So, in that case we are using a strain gauge. What is the best example of a strain gauge is that normally any shop, now electrical weighing machines are available, right? Instead of having analog or classic way of measuring the quantity which we want to get. So, now we are using a electrical weighing machine. So, inside the electrical weighing machine, the strain gauges are set, right? Which converts force or pressure into equivalent electrical output. So it works on the principle of changing the resistance whenever the force or pressure is applied. Then comes your digital transducer, right? So obviously, what is the physical parameter we are measuring, that output is converted into a digital form, right? So here normally we are using a digital encoder, right? So the gray level coding is given like this circle, and which we are dividing into, so we are dividing into transparent and opaque part, and depending upon the transparent opaque part we are getting some pattern. This pattern is nothing but ones, zeros and ones, and ones and zeros the binary form is available, and that is nothing but a digital, right? Then comes your primary transducer and secondary transducer, right? So primary transducer, which converts any physical parameter into mechanical output, okay? So any physical parameter into mechanical output is nothing but your primary transducer. What is secondary transducer? Secondary transducer is nothing but which converts any mechanical input or mechanical parameter into an electrical output. That is what your secondary transducer, okay? Then comes your proximity sensor. What are proximity sensor? Proximity sensors are basically those sensors which can measure the object without any physical touch. Means what? For example, this is there. In order to sense this, I have to touch this. Then I can say that yes, the object is present. But what the proximity sensor will do, if suppose this is a proximity sensor, this will come closer to the distance, and having some distance, it will sense yes, some object is present. So that is what you can say a basic definition of a proximity sensor. Then there are two types of proximity sensors are there. One is your capacitive type of proximity sensor, and second one is your inductive type of proximity sensor. So what is the advantage of proximity sensor? Inductive type of proximity sensor is that in order to measure the metal object, if some metal object is there, and if you want to measure a metal object, the metal object can be easily measured by using proximity sensor. So what basically proximity sensor will do, it will generate RF frequency, and it will keep on sending the RF frequency as long as some object will come. If a metal object is come, what will happen? That field will be induced, and because of that, the net average voltage will be reduced, and from this we can say yes, some object is present. Okay, the question arises, if some non-object metal is there, for example the wood is there, right? So wood is available here, right? Wood is available, then if you want to measure this, what will happen? Being a proximity, inductive type of proximity sensor, what will do? It will generate RF frequency, but being a wood, so this field will not be induced, and this is the greatest drawback of proximity sensor, that he does not detect non-metallic object, right? So in order to overcome that, we are using capacitive type of proximity sensor. In that, you know, capacitive formula, C is equal to epsilon A by D. This is C is equal to epsilon A by D. Right? What it means, the area is directly proportional to the capacitance, and direct distance between the two plate is inversely proportional to the capacitance. So by varying the area or a distance, I can vary the capacitance. Exactly this equation is been employed or deployed for measuring non-metallic capacitance, right? So in that, what we're doing is that one plate is fixed and other plate is taking as an object, moving object. That moving object may be metallic, may not be non-metallic. So it can detect any of these objects. Why? Because distance parameter is there. Here you are looking at distance. So it may be your detecting object may be metal or it may be non-metal. So the principle is that by varying the distance, whatever be the object, if distance is varied, it will detect irrespective of it will be a metallic or non-metallic. So this is what the basic working of your this one, proximity sensor, right? So proximity sensor, a sensor which measures the object without physical contact, having physically touch. Then it is divided into capacitive proximity sensor and inductive type of proximity sensor, right? Then comes your accelerometer and gyroscope. So normally you see this type of you can see latest transducers in your mobile phones also, right? Accelerometer and gyroscope. What is accelerometer? Accelerometer basically measures linear acceleration, right? So alignment, right? So whenever the object is moved, that is been measured by a accelerometer, right? Then what is gyroscope? Gyroscope measures what? Angular rotational velocity, right? So the twist which is given, so it sets and it aligns. So these are the two things which can be done by measured by using accelerometer and gyroscope. So this is what I feel. So today's lecture is regarding sensors and transducers, and I have explained or categorized different types of transducers and sensors along with the definitions. Okay, hope so. This lecture you may find useful to your curriculum. Okay, please do like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.